Hello everyone. For our marketing project proposal, we have invented and curated Apple's next product, the iLens. My name is Dillon Gadoury.
My name is Carmela Noelle, Mamaril.
And my name is Michael Gluzman. So here's our table of contents, giving a brief overview of everything that we are going to cover in our presentation. And now Carmela will begin by giving you a little bit of background on our company, Apple.
Thank you, Michael. To start things off, Apple, as you know, is a multinational technology Goliath. The popular brand was founded in 1976 by Steve Jobs, Steven Wozniak, and Ronald Wayne, starting off their production with the Apple I, a pre-assembled single motherboard desktop computer. The brand has a large cult following with an avid love for its products, some of which are the iPhone, the iPad, and the iPod. One of Apple's most recent successes is an M1 microchip. It offers high-speed processing and a 6 times faster GPU performance than the previous MacBook and iMac versions. Moving on to the strategic focus and plan, I will speak briefly on their mission, goals, and core competencies, as my member Dillon will go over it in more detail later on. So Apple works hard to not only maintain its ground within the competitive market, but to also uphold the vision Steve Jobs had left for the brand. In fact, according to current CEO Tim Cook, Apple strives to bring the best user experience to customers through innovative hardware, software, and services. With every new product, the company aims to produce and manufacture products at premium quality for a premium price. With every large name brand, it's only expected that they have goals to achieve for the upcoming years. For Apple, among those are to maintain its image and position in the competitive market, come out with new innovative products, lessen operating costs, and more. In terms of core competencies, again, Apple works hard in innovating new mobile technologies, getting high quality customer service, and maintaining strong financial performance. The company does indeed stand at a competitive advantage, as their high customer loyalty proves them to be at the top of the technology market. Now onto our SWOT analysis. As a major brand within a competitive industry, there are certainly both internal and external factors that play a role in the market opportunities that Apple encounters. Here we highlight the company's strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats since the moment the brand had made a name for itself. Starting off with strengths, as mentioned, Apple is a technology giant. The company has been able to come out with new products every year and still garner a large cult following that buys out their newest technologies. Their strategy of offering a premium product for a premium price has helped the company to always come out with a higher profit margin. On the other hand, Apple, of course, has its weaknesses. The company limits its distribution network due to its want for exclusivity. Essentially, they pick out authorized retailers to sell their products, such as phone companies, retailers like Best Buy, and of course, their own Apple franchises. By restricting their distribution, Apple is also restricting their market reach as their products become not readily available to other areas. Because Apple has a limited distribution network, it would be a great opportunity for the company to modify its strategy, as a wider network can allow Apple to reach a wider audience. Despite the fact that Apple is a widely known name across the globe, getting over their want for exclusivity can allow them to reach more consumers in the global market. Lastly, we have threats. Knowing that Samsung, Amazon, and even Microsoft are among Apple's greatest competitors is not new information. Samsung is one of, if not Apple's toughest competitor, as they pride themselves on rapid innovation as well. With such strong competitors, it poses a need for the company to take into account stronger strategies to maintain a competitive advantage in software, hardware, and even their online services such as iCloud. Now we have macro environmental factors. Not only as a large name electronics company, but as a business in any industry in general, there are a set of external factors that can impact how businesses function and plan out their strategies. This is where a PESTEL analysis is applied. PESTEL stands for political, economic, sociological, technological, legal, and environmental, all of which are factors that can determine a company's next course of action. Starting off with politics, one of the major impacts for many businesses was Donald Trump's trade war with China in 2018. Essentially, Trump had imposed tariffs on approximately $50 billion worth of Chinese imports. Among those are steel and aluminum. At the time of the tariff imposition, a global trade war was feared. In response to this, China had placed its own tariffs on about $3 billion worth of US imports. However, better and improved free trade policies are implemented over time. This would help to increase Apple's opportunities to distribute more of its products worldwide. Now in economics, we all know that the COVID-19 pandemic had placed many businesses across the globe into tough situations, such as they either had to temporarily halt services or shut down altogether due to economic recession. Though in this current time, the economy is slowly recovering from its losses, uncertainties continue to exist with the pandemic still lingering. Ever since the pandemic had placed many individuals in a situation of no employment or tight finances, Apple's products are deemed to be more of a luxury than a necessity. In regards to social factors, it is commonly known that an ever-growing population will always deem itself to be a social issue. With more people, it is only natural that businesses are going to have to cater to a larger audience with more varied demographic. On the brighter side of things, a larger population ultimately means an increase in support for the growing technology industry. Though online retailing was already in existence, the pandemic had further boosted its operations when most businesses began to work remotely. Online retailing can actually help businesses reach a wider range of consumers. They're able to easily compare and contrast products and be more educated on the purchases they are making with the simple click of a button. Additionally, business can conduct exclusive online sales to further encourage people to shop online. This way, Apple can push their customers to buy more products because of attractive deals. Now, concerning legal factors, one of Apple's greatest issues is its privacy policy. It comes to no surprise that the government is taking advantage of its power over businesses to not only pry into, but also regulate information that comes and goes into our devices. This poses a threat to Apple and, of course, in its course of action, as it could potentially impose more investments into privacy regulation compliance requirements and further possible restrictions on how its products operate. Finally, we have environmental factors. Sustainability within business has been a consistent factor over the years as we face growing concerns for the environment. Society is looking towards these major industries to adopt more sustainable practices in order to cater to the growing concerns about the environmental impact. Apple has been doing a great job in improving its operational investments to address environmental concerns, as well as continuing to showcase these attractive technologies. Moving on, I will hand it over to Dillon to talk about our market product focus.
Thank you so much, Carmela. You can go to the next slide. So when developing our iLens, we wanted to develop a mission, as Apple does with all of our products. And with the iLens, our overarching mission was to market a high-quality contact lens that showcased the perspective and point of view of all Apple users. With a premium product at a premium price, Apple is focused on having less in your hand and more in front of you, as it enhances our day-to-day lives, promoting features everyday users would typically utilize in their back pocket, but now are right in front of their eyes. Next slide, please. So when looking at our mission, we wanted to look long-term. And what better than a five-year long-term goal to help guide us for the iLens. We divided this between non-financial goals and some financial goals. I won't be going over all of them, but just to highlight some. As Apple, with all of our products, we hope that they maintain and further enhance our image as the highest quality line of technology in today's society. Another goal was that in 5 years to have all, or 12.5% of all Apple product users, in one fiscal year, to have 12.5% of all Apple users purchase and use the iLens. This not only would help us with gathering feedback and information, but this would also redirect us into another non-financial goal, which is helping us develop a better product in the following years. We hope to develop another iLens every second year with the iLens Plus and the version of the colored eye contacts. For some financial goals, we hope to obtain a return on equity of at least 25% on the iLens throughout the 5 years. Along with that, with all our products, we hope to increase the public stock, further valuing our company and promoting investments. Next slide, please. So when developing the product, we wanted to look for a specific market we wanted to target. And on a more broad scale, this product is for all ages and genders. Everyone can use this product. And it does feature built-in custom prescriptions. So it would also target the direct audience of those who require prescriptions and glasses, because we do know glasses are a bit of an inconvenience. A big feature of the iLens product is its augmented reality and its virtual reality. So this creates a whole new door for potential with video game and app developers with this virtual reality features, companies that develop games, or even want to use holograms within their applications, can partner with Apple in developing UI UX designs and coding softwares that would excel with the promotion of the iLens. There are additional features with the iLens, including the health app, Apple Watch, Bluetooth features, digital sharing, and more. And we really wanted to focus the iLens around this targeted market, the targeted market of consumers who really care about productivity and accessibility to be the best at what they do. Next slide, please. So next, onto the marketing program, we're gonna break down the four P's of marketing and how we find success with the iLens. Next slide. So products, and I like to look at this as step one. We ask ourselves, what do our customers want from our product and service? And what features of our product slash service work to meet our customers' needs? So Apple knew that the strengths of this iLens lied in the features that it provided. 4K 60 frames per second, video recording, health analysis data, AirDrop, Bluetooth, virtual reality, and contactless communication are all innovative ways of how we use our current technology. Imagine texting someone or replying to someone and changing a song without even touching anything, without holding a phone. You can control everything in front of you with more life. We wanted to pair this with the Apple Watch for health and fitness. We're going to pair with the iPhone for contactless communication and VR for applications on the phone, and Apple AirPods for music system controlled through the iLens, fully contactless. All of the features are interconnected through Apple, so it makes it very easy. Next slide. Price. We knew price was going to be a weakness, as Carmela mentioned earlier, and that's something that we always have to overcome. The iLens is something the world has never seen before, so it is quite daunting when you see the price of $1,899 without really knowing what's coming with it. So we use quite a few techniques with making it seem less daunting and more valuable for your dollar. Right off the bat, we offer monthly payment plans, so it seems like it's less hitting your bank and it's more financially affordable for those who rely on paycheck to paycheck. If you don't require a prescription, we knock off $150, so we'd be starting at $1,749. And after the first two fiscal quarters, after it is announced, we do drop the price a little bit so it is more accessible to the general public. And as I mentioned before, when we release different versions of the iLens with the iLens Plus and the iLens 2.0, the original price of the iLens is going to drop, making it even more accessible to the public. Next slide. So price continued. I like to call this section more bang for your buck. And this is through the bundles that Apple does. And what we're going to be doing with the iLens in the future time when the iLens is announced. In this bundle that we're going to be dropping, we're going to be promoting the AirPods Max, which recently came out in fall this past year, as well as the iLens, targeting it more for college students who really care about productivity and focusing in on focus. We punchlined at the maximum college student bundle starting at $19.99 instead of $18.99 for just the iLens, and giving the offer of paying monthly. So this bundle is really gonna highlight Bluetooth connectivity, controlling music from your iLens, replying to people, and really just staying in focus what we're doing. We've seen bundles like this before for college students with buying an iPad and getting a free AirPods. But this is gonna be a brand new bundle that makes consumers feel like that they're getting more out of their, more for their dollar, and it seems more worth it to them by only adding $100 for something, the AirPods Max that usually costs $300. Next slide, please. So promotions. Promotions is gonna be one of the most important qualities. If you have a great product, how are people gonna know about it? So we ask ourselves, how is this gonna reach our audience? And where will we send our marketing messages to our targeted audience? In today's society, we rely heavily on social media for our marketing promotion, seen through television advertisements, YouTube ads, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook promotions. When we announce a new product, the whole world will know about it in a matter of seconds. And same with the iLens. Social media allows us to promote our products easier, more effectively, and more personalized than ever before, which leads to greater outcomes and ever-increasing profits. So key factors in our promotions are going to be the features. The video and photo capturing, AirDrop accessibility, Bluetooth compatibility, VR health analysis, and the iLens captures. Along with social media and intangible promoting, we're going to do physical promoting with billboards in highly populated urban areas, for example, like Times Square. And we always see those big shot on the iPhone billboards. Hopefully within the coming years, we can have shot on iLens. Next slide, please. Lastly, we have place. We can have an amazing product at a fairly great price with fantastic promotions, but how is it going to be successful when consumers don't know where to buy this product at? So we have to identify the marketing channel strategy to find the best ways to expose our service and our product and brand to possible consumers. So we have to figure out where customers are shopping and how they are engaging on social media. So we're going to start small. We know that most consumers are going to go to Target, Best Buy, and Walmart for these type of products. So we'll send a limited amount of quantities to these large name retailers. After a few months, we'll analyze their performance and see how well they did. And from then, we can focus on our supply chains. If they're doing really well in these stores, we can send more. If they're doing all right, we can send them less. And over time, always focus on how much we're making, on how much we're losing, if people are buying, if people are not. What's great with collaborating with retailers is that we get to work with their marketing, their production teams that get to showcase that they have Apple iLenses in their store, which further create more traffic and more exposure on their social medias, which will only create more revenue and profits for us. Lastly, we always have the Apple website and the Apple store as a place for you can buy it. Apple stores physically, we have the team in stores, the workers who are going to be a second line of promotion, who are going to be well-versed on the product and the features, who are going to be that last line that convince you and pull you in on edge. And as always, we always have the Apple website within our promotions to let you know that you can buy it on the Apple store. Next slide. I will now be passing you on to Michael to go over financial data and projections.
Thank you, Dillon. I will be taking you guys through our financial data and our projections for the iLens. So to begin, I think it's key to look at Apple's quarterly revenue since 2005. The key trend to point out here is that Apple's revenue peaks annually in the first quarter. Their first quarter begins September 25th and runs through the end of the year, December 31st. And this quarter is always their highest because they get to capture the release of their products, Black Friday, and the holiday season. Next slide. For the next 5 years, we have projected the revenue and net sales for the iLens. This is a very conservative estimate because we are unsure of the consumer sentiment towards such an experimental and futuristic product. Just note that all these quantities could be increased by a factor of 10 or even 100 if the consumers want to buy the iLens and feel comfortable putting the iLens in their eye. So in year one, hypothetically, we have 100,000 units sold with an increase of 75,000 to 175 in year two, then an increase by another 100,000 units in year three to 285, and then an increase by 115,000 into year four, 400,000, and then 50,000 more in year five. We expect these to keep growing on an annual basis and match up with the same revenue patterns as Apple's other products. Next slide. So next is our implementation plan. As for everything that Carmela and Dillon outlined in their portion of the presentation, everything needs to be implemented on a timely and organized basis. So next slide. We have prepared a Gantt chart to show how we plan on launching the iLens product, the iLens marketing campaign, and the promotion for the iLens. So first comes the product development and the market research, followed by our marketing campaign in the next two quarters. And at the end of those two quarters, we are able to ensure the successful release of the iLens. And after the iLens is done, the most important thing that we will be doing to ensure that the consumers are buying it and feel comfortable buying the iLens is launching extensive consumer sentiment research. And up through our consumer sentiment research, that is essentially the base of a cycle that we will be repeating on an annual basis as we launch the iLens Plus, the iLens 2, and the iLens 2 Plus. We will be conducting the marketing campaign, the product development, and the market research every single time we release a new iLens. Next chart, evaluation. So not everything goes as planned in marketing, and it is important to have backup plans. So first we must create criteria to examine the success of our product. We will compare the projected sales versus the actual sales. And if they are not matching up, if the actual sales are not matching or exceeding the projected sales, then we will have to launch promotions, which may include bundling the iLens with AirPods, or even offering an Apple gift card with the purchase of iLens, just to get the product into more consumers' hands. Next slide. The more important evaluation will be the consumer evaluation. As mentioned earlier, the iLens is a very new high-tech product, and it is a foreign object going inside your body. And rightfully so, consumers may be concerned about the product purchasing the product. However, it is our job as marketers to make the customers feel that the product is safe, that the product is revolutionary, which it is, and that the product will improve the quality of their life within every aspect: health, work, family, socially, all of them. That's all I've got for the evaluation. Next slide.
This is our works cited. Next slide, please. And that concludes our presentation. Thank you so much.